Hi, this is Akash. For my project in pattern recognition, I've done analysis of naive Bayesian spam filter and the effects of various Bayesian poisoning techniques on the filter. So, emails or electronic mail is one of the most widely used means of communication currently. So, it is commonly used in both professional and personal settings. It is so popular that there are nearly 269 billion emails sent per day on an average. Unnecessary messages or bad emails are called spam. 60% of the 269 billion emails that are sent per day are spam. These are sent by spammers. This is why we need to filter out these spam from the good mail or ham, and that is why spam filters are very important. So what does a spam filter do? It automatically classifies email as spam or ham and shows us only the good emails or ham. So I've implemented two filters and compared them both initially, and then we are going to look into the Bayesian poisoning techniques that is tried to reduce the accuracy of one of the filters. So the first filter that I've implemented is the Bayes filter, or the naive Bayes filter, which is based on the Bayes theorem. So let's look into what the Bayes theorem is. Bayes theorem is used mainly for conditional probability. So it means that what is the probability of some event occurring given that something else is given, right? So P of S given that W has happened means that is the conditional probability that a given mail is spam when it is known that the word W is present in it. So for each word, the filter basically calculates the probability that the word occurs given that the email is spam, and then based on that we calculate the overall probability of whether an email is spam or ham. So by combining the a probability of all the words that occur in the spam body, we get to decide based on the probability whether the email is actually spam or ham. That is, whether the email has more words that occur usually in spam or whether it has more words that occur in good mails. So this is how we basically implement the Bayes filter. The process is that we use a training set to once implemented, we use a training set to train the filter as to what emails are good and what emails are bad. So initially the training set that I've used consists of 760 emails, of which this is the train mails, consist of the emails that I've used for training the filter. And of the 760, 702 emails, the 351 are ham, and the rest of the 351 are spam. So once the emails are trained on this, then we use a test data set to test whether the email to test the accuracy of the spam filter. Another spam filter that I've implemented is the support vector machine filter. So this basically divides the emails into ham and spam by splitting the data by a hyperplane. As you can see from the image, the hyperplane ensures that maximum margin is there between the two classes. And it is highly memory efficient because it uses a subset of the data that is there. So basically it just uses the boundaries called the support vectors. So the support vectors are all that is needed, and anything below the support vector is classified into one category, and anything above the other support vector is classified into the other category. And that is why this is highly memory efficient. Now let's go into some of the implementation code. So what I've done is I've implemented, I've created seven different sets of data sets So the train mail basically implements all the is the training set, whereas the test mails represent the 360 emails that, sorry, 260 emails that are going to be tested, of which 130 is ham and 130 is spam. So let's look at the code first. So what basically happens in both the filters is that they first create a dictionary of words, and then they count the occurrence of the words, and by removing the words, like common words like a, in, and extra special characters, we ensure that the probability calculations are right. Then for each email, a feature vector is created, and then this collection of feature vectors is fit on the models. So the first model is a linear SVC model, that is basically the SVM filter. And the next model that we have created is the multinomial naive Bayes, and that is basically the naive Bayes filter. Well, as you can see, I'll show you some of the results over here. By running the running this, we see that both of the filters return results over here. So as seen from the table, we notice that naive Bayes filter and the SVM filter both have very similar accuracies. Naive Bayes filter has a slightly higher accuracy than the SVM filter. Now let me define what false positive rate and false negative rate is. False positive rate means that a ham mail or a good mail is wrongly classified as spam and thrown out by the filter. And false negative rate means that a spam is wrongly classified as a good mail and gets through the filter. Well, it is pretty obvious that having a low false positive rate is very important, because no one wants to lose any of their good mails. This is why the naive Bayes filter is chosen over the SVM filter. That is why it is more popular than the SVM filter, even though the SVM filter is more memory efficient and faster. So let's go into the Bayesian poisoning techniques. So Bayesian poisoning techniques are used by spammers to reduce the accuracy of the Bayes filter. So it tries to make the filter mistake spam as ham, so that they can send more spam emails through the filter. So three common poisoning techniques that are used by the spammers are random words attack, the common words attack, and the ham phrase attack. So what does the random words attack do? Random words attack basically adds words to the spam body, random words to the spam body. So this pseudocode here shows how to add 100 random words to the body of each spam mail. On running this code, give me a second. On running this code, random words attack, we basically modify the test mail data set so that each spam mail has 100 random words appended to it, to its body. And then on running the naive Bayes filter on that, as you can see from the highlighted thing, we have used the data set random 100, which means that there are 100 random words in the data set. 100 random words added to each spam body in the data set. So on running this, we notice that there is no significant effect on the naive Bayes filter. And on adding 1,000 random words, that is, having a random word attack and using 1,000 words, that is writing 1,000 words into the spam body, still has a very slight effect. Only one spam got through it. Now, what we understand from this is that this random word attack is not a very strong mode of attack. It's not the most effective. Going back to the that is summarized in this table. As you can see, the false positive rate stays the same. The false negative rate just increases by a little, even though 1,000 words have been added. As you can see from the last row in the table. Now, common words attack is kind of similar to random words, but uses more common words. So basically what this means is that common words are added, random common words are added to the spam mail body. So what I've done is I've created a file that has common words as highlighted here. So random words from this are read by the program and then written into the spam mail body. So you can see I've appended a data set known as common 100, which means that there are 100 common words in each spam mail body in that data set. On running it, this is the data that we get. We see that this has more of an effect on the naive Bayes filter, and 7 more spam mail have gotten through when we add 100 words to each spam mail. On adding 1,000 mails, as highlighted by the common 1,000 data set that I've used, so this data set basically means that each spam mail has 1,000 words, 1,000 common words added to its spam. Then we see that 90 spam mail get through as because they are classified as ham, as in that is they are classified as good mail. This means that the common words attack is pretty strong. The final attack that I've analyzed is the ham phrase attack. This means that actual words from the good emails are copied by the spammer and added to the spam mails. This is one of the most dangerous kinds of attack, and it is the smartest attack that I've analyzed here. As you would see from the code here, I basically copied the ham mail data into a file called ham phrases.txt, and then read 100 random words from that and written it into each spam mail body. As you can see, on just adding 100 emails, as in 100 words, 100 ham phrases to each spam spam body, there's a drastic effect and 77 spam mails get through. And on adding 1,000 ham words to each email, we see that almost all the spam mails get through, which means that the filter has been compromised, but useless by this attack. It is clearly evident from this table, as you can see, the false negative rate is nearly 0.98, the probability, which means it's like 98.5% of the spam get through the filter when this attack is used. So to summarize, Bayes spam filter is preferred over the SVM filter due to its low positive rate. So from a spammer perspective, the ham phrase attack is highly greater than the common words attack, which is greater than the random words attack. So common words and random words attack can be made important or can be trained against by training the filter on more data. But if the spammer keeps changing the ham phrases, then that attack cannot be prevented. That is why ham phrase attack has no defense against it. This is why we need to create better filters in the future and keep researching, so that we can always stay ahead of the spammers. Thank you.